Peace, everybody. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. And this morning, I'm doing a video on my way to work, driving. And I just thought, you know, it's time for me to cut the bullshit and to really talk about what I really feel about these black female-male relationships in America. And I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm so sick of the shit, I don't know what to do. You understand? If people are so fucking confused, and I was one of them when I was younger, as to what type of relationship I want to have as a woman. And, you know, when I was younger, I was trying to mirror my relationship, you know, what I wanted off other people. And I'm telling you today that your relationship is as individual as your damn fingerprint, okay? And one of the things they used to really, you know, particularly, I'm going to tell you, it really started manifesting itself when I came into so-called what you call consciousness, which is really nothing but, you know, getting some black history under your belt, listening to some black scholars, you know, learning about your health and, you know, all those things like that. That's basically what consciousness is, okay? It's just being aware of, you know, your surroundings and things like that. So I decided that, you know, what is it that irritates me about black men, okay? And I just have to be honest with each and every one of you, because I remember when I used to try to play into this shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I used to feel so sorry for these niggas. And I'm just done with that, because I'm going to tell you something. We always talk about no other race woman talk about their man like the black woman. Well, no other race whines and cries like the goddamn black man and the damn white man. I'm telling you, it's unbelievable. Y'all the whiningest men I ever seen in my damn life. And it just irritates me. And as a black woman, I gotta listen to the black man whining all the fucking time. Okay, about the white man, what the white man doing. Now, he can't blame the white man for his situation. Well, he does. But the one he really wants to slap around and hit upside the head is the black woman, instead of stepping to that fucking white man. You see, and I'm gonna tell you something about a woman, you know, particularly myself. I don't like no weak ass man. I don't like no man always whining and crying about the white man and what they doing and white supremacy and how that's keeping them down and all that bullshit. That irritates me, okay? Because there are some black men who are doing the thing, all right? So all these whiny ass black men, they irritate me, you know? And black women, I'm going to tell y'all something. Y'all keep whining about ain't no good black men out here and all that damn bullshit like that. Well, you got to pick and choose better. I'm just going to put that on record for you. You understand? You got to know what you want in a man. You know, what kind of man is for you. Now, I know a lot of y'all got these high ideals where you want a nigga to take care of your ass and whine and dine your ass and rock and still call yourself an independent woman. It don't work like that. Either you gonna be a fucking dependent or you're not. Simple as that. If you're gonna be an independent woman and you want a man that's comparable with you, that means that y'all gotta pool resources. You know, it can't be no one-upmanship. You know, simply because you make more money than your man, that you in turn want to be a ruler. And see, that's another thing that irritates me too, is this goddamn rulership mentality that men have. They want to rule over the household, and I'm saying that fucking shit does not work today. Okay, nobody wants to be ruled over once we understood what ruling was. You understand? Because rulership means you get the last fucking word, and your ass ain't perfect, and your ass ain't, excuse me, it's not always right. And so I just had to set the record straight today to let you know exactly how I feel. You know, the psychology that I have as far as these male, female, black, female relationships go. And the fact that don't no woman respect no whining ass man. I'm just going to put that on record. I don't give a fuck how aware of white supremacy we are. We do not like no whining ass man always talking about another fucking man holding them down. I'm just going to put that on record for you. And this is probably going to be my last video on this type of subject, unless somebody say some slick ass shit that I feel I have to address. You understand? But I'm tired of it. I'm done. I'm finished. You know, let those who want to do the bashing videos do them so they can gain viewerships. That's their damn business. I really don't give two shits about them. You understand? From this point forward, I'm going to be trying to focus on my business. You know, I'm a jewelry designer. That's what I do. All this opinion shit ain't got me one motherfucking customer. Okay? So, this shit is over. Man, I'm so sick of y'all, I don't know what to do. You know, I'm 60 years old. I've been looking at this shit for damn near, 40 years at the most. And I'm going to tell you, y'all ain't come no closer to unity. Y'all ain't come no closer to that illusion called unity than from the first time I heard about it. Oh, we need black unity. Black people need to unify. That's some bullshit too, because you ain't did it, and goddamn, I don't know since you've been calling for it. Okay, so, you know, this is it. I just got to tell y'all the truth about how I feel about this shit, because I think y'all fucking ridiculous. You understand? Live your life. Grow your family. Set the rules inside your house. Fuck what other people is doing is what I'm trying to say. And I'm going to tell you, you'll find those that do that, they live better. Okay? People who ain't so always worried about what other black folk doing. All right? So, you know what? That's where I'm focused, because I'm tired of the bullshit. You know, and I'm telling men, quit fucking complaining all the time about other men. Other white men. You know, and white men need to quit complaining too. Because there's some complaining bastards as well, even though they're supposed to be the, you know, they're supposed to run every fucking thing. But these motherfuckers, I'm going to tell you, the 1% ain't complaining about shit. It's all these low-level motherfucking white folk down here that's complaining. Oh, it's the blacks that's keeping the country in this. Oh, it's the immigrants that's doing this to the country. Yeah, I mean, all that fucking complaining, I'm sick of y'all. I don't know why y'all women don't be in y'all asses for all that goddamn complaining y'all be doing. You understand? Just take care of your fucking family. That's all you gotta do too. And we'll have some fucking peace on this goddamn planet. Instead of trying to get every motherfucker to conform to your idea and way of living. It don't work like that. I just got to put this on record. Because that's why we got so much confusion in the goddamn world. You know, it's men. Men confused about what they are and who they are and what they're supposed to do when evolution is constantly happening. Okay, the woman is changing. The children are changing. Every motherfucker's changing but the whining ass man. Straighten your ass up. Straighten your back up and take care of your family. That's what you here for. Okay, you here to mate up, suit up, and take care of your family. That's what you're for. Women, you're here to woman up, suit up, and take care of your immediate family. We ain't got no business all outside our families. You understand? Even though I know that they say, oh, the environment. See, it's your environment that'll affect you. Yeah, but you got to insulate yourself from your environment. Sometimes you can't help but live in certain environments, but you can also psychologically tune yourself out to that environment too. All right, so I'm not one that says that environment can influence you. It can influence a uninformed motherfucker. I'm just going to put that on record too. Okay, like I said, I'm just fucking tired. This morning I woke up and I'm like, that's it. You know, I'm like, that's it. I'm taking the gloves off. This is it. This is what the queen thinks. I'm tired of trying to coddle motherfuckers and make them feel, you know, all good and shit, you know, trying to mince my words for them. I'm not doing that no more. Quit your fucking whining and live your damn life. You know, if you got to work every day, then go do your fucking job what you signed up to. Okay, if you don't want to work, then quit. Be on welfare. Do whatever the fuck you want to. But don't blame that shit on me. Okay? Don't blame that shit on other people. Blame that shit on yourself. Okay? Look, let me tell you something. Well, you know, it's less black men in college. Well, why is it less black men in college? Because they don't go. God damn it, that's why. They don't go. You know, some men smart enough to see that, hey, everybody ain't gonna go to college. But to sit around and whine about that shit and use statistics, get the fuck out of here. You understand? Oh, it's more black women than it is black men. Oh, it's more women with jobs than it is black men. Yeah, you know what? Y'all just some sick ass motherfucking people. You understand? I'm sorry I'm part of you. Because it does all this whining and shit ain't never got us nothing. I've been listening to this shit for 40 fucking years, and it ain't got us nothing. As a matter of fact, it done fractured us even more. You know what I'm saying? It done separated us even more, is what I'm trying to say to y'all. So, you know, my thing is I'm gonna live my fucking life. And like I said, all this opinionated shit I've been commenting on ain't got me one fucking customer. I'm a jewelry designer. Ain't not one of you, except for a few of you. And well, I ain't gonna say nobody ever bought anything. But that off of YouTube, you know, one of my subscribers done patronized my business. But we always talk about business and all this kind of shit. Look, that whoever these manufacturers are right here, they got y'all asses by the nose, okay? You know, you keep talking about how much money we spend and how much income we be spending and all that shit. Well, honey, let me tell you, they ain't twisting your arm and making you go out to them damn stores. Keep complaining about the Asians coming in your community, the Indians coming in your community. They ain't twisting your arm to go into their stores. You going in there. So quit fucking complaining about it. You understand? And do what you got to do. You know, but I'm just tired of the fucking complaining. And like I said, you know, when it come to me, and I never liked a whining ass man that's always whining about what somebody else is doing to him, what he can't do, who's holding him back, and all that shit. I'm going to tell you something. Nothing holds a man back. As a matter of fact, I'm going to make it even more broader. Nothing holds back a determined motherfucker. Okay, if you determine whether you male or female, you go have what you want in life. All right, but it seems to me, it appears to me, that a lot of you want shit handed to you on a silver platter. It don't work like that. You understand? Even the motherfuckers you talking about had to actually put some work in to get where they are. All right, so that means that you go have to put some work in to get where you want to be. Not where they are, because they already there. But I'm saying to get where you want to be. You understand? Now, I understand that we have to deal with a psychology, you know, of black people who, you know, think the white man's ice is colder. I mean, or the Asian's ice is colder, or the Indian's ice is colder, because, you know, they won't patronize your business. But goddamn, are your prices comparable? Because I'm telling you, it's all about economics. And if, you know, let me just say this too. I find it interesting that it costs more to represent your African side than it does any other side in America. You know, I look at some of these prices of African clothing, and now, trust me, I know how much it costs to make that shit, right? But see, the thing is, they tell me things like, well, how much it costs to bring it over here to America and all that bullshit like that. And I'm like, well, shit, why come we ain't on our government officials to try to see the unfairness of these import-export laws and stuff like that? Why aren't we working on that? You know, we want to represent ourselves as African people, or, you know, associate ourselves with African people and, you know, wear the cultural clothing that we want to wear. You know, it seems to me that that's a little elitist. But guess who came in and did the knockoffs? The motherfucking Asians. Okay, you can go get you a little African looking dress at the little Asian store for $19.99. Okay, you can wear it on Juneteenth or Black History Month or something like that, you know, as opposed to spending hundreds of dollars on some of these authentic African clothing. All you want to do is have a look, all right, basically, you know, and I just think that's such a ripoff, you know what I'm saying? And as a matter of fact, that's what started me to designing jewelry in the first place, is that some of the pieces that I wanted was just ridiculously high. You understand? And I'm like, you know, and having, you know, as a hobby made jewelry, I knew how much it cost to make that shit. And I'm like, hell no. These, you know, so I start making jewelry myself and wearing my own jewelry. And then people start really liking my stuff. And so that's when I turned it into a business in 1997. But, you know, we just got so many people that munch off us. You know, munch off our stupidity, munch off our longing to belong some fucking where. You know, when you make your own place in life, you understand, they got you, so you going and did DNA test and ain't now one of y'all geneticists, but you believe what they tell y'all, that y'all come from certain some place genetically, but they can do that with any goddamn body. I'm just gonna put that on record for you, okay? You can point on a map and say, hey, I'm gonna claim that area right there as my ancestor. I mean, and come up with the same shit. I'm just wondering, that I guess for many of you, it's psychological. It makes you feel better that you could say you're from the Burundi tribe or some shit like that. But for me, I don't need that to be African. I'm going to just say that again. I keep saying it. I don't need that to prove that I'm an African of African descent. I can just look at my fucking face. Okay? And I can go on that continent and find my face in a whole bunch of them goddamn countries. All right? So I don't play into, you know, oh, we don't know who we are. I sure know who in the fuck I am. I'm just going to put that on record for y'all. Okay? I just want to make that shit clear that I know who I am. I ain't never been confused about who I am. Okay? Now, I'll tell you, I've been confused, not confused, but puzzled about what my role is. Now, I've been there and I had to reestablish my own damn role. You understand? I created my own damn role. What I'm going to do and what I'm not going to do. Okay? Simple as that. You know, it's all so individual, and everybody wants to find this cookie cutter so we can all be the same, and we're not the same. And you're going to find people that you get along with and you jive with and you, you know, can work with. And then you go find people that you can't. That's just how it works in life, you know. So all that shit y'all be talking about, we go be a one man. We have unity and all that shit. Nah, you ain't going, you don't even, look, let me tell y'all something. Y'all don't even, as African people here in America, call yourself African Americans. You ain't even got a fucking flag. You got one, but you don't acknowledge it. And that's that red, black, and green flag that was designated for us by the Honorable Brother Marcus Garvey. But y'all don't rock that. You understand? In my neighborhood, man, I see that Puerto Rican flag and that Mexican flag all the time right here in America. So I'm telling a whole lot of y'all, y'all just full of shit. You know? Y'all just want to complain about something and you really want to make up for your lack of enthusiasm and being able to put your best foot forward, you know, in the world. You know, you go get jobs, you can't hold a motherfucker because you don't know how to work. You sign on to a contract and then you want to go in there and change the shit, and that ain't your damn job. Okay, your job is to do what you contracted to do, and if you don't like it, then get the fuck out. Okay? You know, I see a whole lot of that shit, you know, and I'm just voicing my opinion today about it. Because a lot of y'all ain't up but whining ass babies, and it makes me sick. You know, I'm old enough to say what I can say right now. You know, and I told y'all, when I turn 60, I'm going to say some shit. And y'all ain't going to like it, and I really don't give a fuck. Okay? I really could give two shits about how each and every one of you feel from this point forward. Because I've observed you. Okay, you know, particularly those that have the nerve, the guts, the balls, and the money to get on the internet and talk some shit. Okay, I've observed you over the years, and I'm gonna say to each and every one of y'all that complaining and whining and crying about the black man, the black woman, and all that motherfucking shit, you need to take a look at your own damn self. How is your fucking life? How is things going with you? You understand? If you in a relationship, what role do you play in the damn relationship? Is it in agreement with your partner's role? All right? Because some of y'all trying to fit a round peg in a square fucking hole, and that ain't never worked. All right? So you need to get your lives together. You understand? I done been through it. Okay? My life ain't been perfect. That's why but I'm alive to tell you that I'm okay today. Okay, I'm okay today, and ain't never had a man take care of me. Ain't never had a man whining and dining me. All you women need to shut the fuck up with your independent ass. Okay, if you so independent, then you don't need all that shit. All right, you need a man, and you and he are going to work together, have children, raise your children to be how you want them to be, give them the morals and values that you think are correct and exact, and keep it moving and quit blaming other fucking people for your damn downfall. That's all I can say today. And this is how I'm feeling this morning. I think it's February the 5th. I'm not sure, but I know it's Tuesday. Okay, morning on my way to work. And so I decided that I'm going to do a very truthful video. After all, I am the truth terrorist. And I must tell you what I consider and what I think is the truth for me. And what I see, you know. And that's my... I didn't know that was blowing like that. That's my heater. I had to cut my heater on because my hands was cold. But anyway, I'm going to tell you, I ain't never had problems in my life getting what I want. And I'm going to tell you, I'm poor as Job. I don't make a lot of money. I don't have a lot of money. I don't have one of those high-level, high-power-ass jobs. I'm just a working sister who's been working for the past, 30-something years. And who, prior to that, worked the streets. Okay? So I know about street life, and I know about work life. All right? And I know what makes you successful in this society. Okay, and what makes you successful is you setting your own parameters in your life as to what you want and what you want to do. All right, nobody controls you. Okay, nobody has control over you. I just want to put that on record. You allow people to have control over you because of what you desire. You want something that they have, okay, that they ain't giving to you. All right, so quit begging. Quit asking and go out there and make your own life. Make your own. If that means if you have to work, then you go and do that. But you have a plan for how long you want to work and things like that. Sometimes you have to delay some gratifications till later on. This is what I taught my daughter, which is why she's a success right now. She's about to go into get her. I forgot what she called it, because I don't be following education that much, you know, but she's going to get some, I think it's, I don't know if it's a master's degree or one of them damn degrees that people get, but my point is, you know, as far as women just go for it. I don't know why men, you know, be complaining, but like I said, James Morgan dispelled that fucking shit for me, you know, all that bullshit about black men not in college and all that shit. He put the numbers out there for me, I believe he is. So I don't want to continue to hear all that whining and crying from me, and I ain't got no sympathy for you no more. I used to feel sorry for you. I don't feel sorry for you no more, okay? And women, I don't feel sorry for you either when you get with these knucklehead ass niggas who ain't doing shit, you know, to help you to enhance your life just like you're supposed to enhance their lives. Okay? Ain't nobody out here born to take care of you. Okay, I'm gonna put that on record, and that's been what's been keeping women down all through the fucking flick, is that these men have made you dependent on them. But as the advent of the goddamn women's liberation movement, it showed you that you could take care of your goddamn self. Okay, bottom line. So for all of you independent women out there who are always talking about how independent you are, how much money you make, how much this, and then like one brother said, then you turn around and ask them to buy you a drink. I find that to be fucking ridiculous. Okay, you know, if you want to be like up on par with men and all that kind of shit like that, then you can't be, you know, asking for special privileges. Okay, I'm just gonna put that on record. You can't be taken care of and be independent too. Okay, you can't be catered to and be independent too. It just doesn't work like that. All right, so anyway, you know, for all my sisters out there that's doing their thing, whether they got a mate or not, that's raising their children, kudos to you. And to all my brothers out there who are, you know, raising their children, if they're single, if they're you know raising a child alone, because one brother made something very clear to me, and it made a whole lot of sense when he said that there's no such thing as a single parent. And I thought about that, and I was like, you know what, he's right. And his explanation was this: if you have a child, you're not single. Okay, you're not a single parent, you're in a relationship. Okay, with this child. So you're not a single parent. So you're raising a child, you know, alone, singly. And like this brother said, you know, we are, you know, affected with single-mindedness, and that's what we have, is single-mindedness. Even if you have children, you have people that are single-minded. They still want to be single, but they're not single. Okay? So You know, I just had to get this off my chest. I don't know when I might do another damn video, like I said, because I'm tired of this. You know, I really got to focus on my business, because there's sisters out there that, you know, can rock my shit like I want them to rock it. You know what I'm saying? I don't sell my jewelry to everybody. I'm just going, you know, across. I'm going to tell you, because it's certain sisters that, you know, can rock this. Everybody can't wear this type of jewelry. All right, so I'm always looking for the sisters that, you know, and those are the ones that'll be attracted to it. You know, and I don't think my jewelry is expensive. So anyway, that's what I'm gonna be focusing on from this point forward. I am not gonna be worried about you black folk and your male-female relationship problems. I've had mine, been there, done that, analyzed it, fixed it, and I'm moving on, okay? Because I'm 60. I ain't trying to have no children. I'm not trying to get no boyfriend. I'm not trying to have no man. You understand? I'm not looking for all that, because that's not what I need. Now, for those of you in your childbearing years, you know, just be careful about the mates that you choose that you want to bear children for. You know, simple as that. And know that every time you lay down and fuck, there's a possibility that you may have a child if you have not protected yourself with some kind of, you know, protecting devices. So I'm just letting you know that whatever happens, it's up to you. At the end of the day, you make the choices, you make the action. It's all up to you. Whether they turn out good or bad, it's all up to you. And ain't nothing, I'm gonna leave you with this, there's nothing like a well thought out plan. I'm just gonna put that on record for you. You know, because a lot of y'all live that one day at a time, day by day shit. But I'm gonna tell you, ain't nothing wrong with planning. Ain't nothing wrong with planning your children. You know, how many children you go have, when you go have them. There's nothing wrong with doing that. You know, I'm telling you, it makes your life much easier because you're prepared. But anyway, with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist. Just got to tell it like it is, because I'm just a little tired of listening to all the goddamn bullshit. You know, I just thought I'd set the record straight from my perspective. If you don't like it, that's your business. I'm out of here. In peace, everybody.